Okay, welcome to Friday Night Frights. It's not Kaleo.
It's better.
It's not Killer Cow. It's me, Tony Midnight. Hey, Paisana. How you doing, man?
A little bit too local for Paisan.
You doing? Hey,
you need
good
pasta.
To see Rocky,
I
man.
I actually acknowledge this as a good attempt. Keep going. Keep going.
Yeah, no,
I like
no,
this.
No, attempt is fine.
Come on, keep going.
Rocky's a good movie, man.
Well, you know. I was like, yo, Adrian. And then I'll just beat Apollo. Yeah, you know, I don't know. I can't do it.
Wow.
Yeah. I went there.
I'm walking here.
Oh,
I wish I grew up in New York City.
Oh, I the wish accents I grew, we would have, man.
I wish I grew up in Evans City, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. No, Evans City, Pennsylvania.
Oh, because of George R. Romero?
George A. Romero? That's right, everybody. It's a Night of the Living Dead episode.
Have you ever seen the parody they did for that movie?
Well, there have been several.
Well, I was like, the only one I was exposed to was G4's Night of the Tripping Den.
Oh, okay.
Which is,
G4?
Yeah, because G4 TV did a special where it's Night of the Living Dead's movie, just redubbed in the weirdest slang ever.
Whoa.
Yeah. It was really weird.
Like ghetto, like yo, what's up, man?
Kind of, and then imagine Crazy Eddie commercials coming at you.
Orale, vato.
Something like that, yeah. I think Cheech was a voiceover for that show.
No, not Cheech. Who's Cheech?
Roll a fatty and you'll find out.
Yeah.
Marin?
He's finding Chong right now.
Yeah.
Chong? Wait, I gotta get the notes out. Where's the notes? It's inside Ali B. Which is not here today.
But if it's inside Ali B, look out.
It's just her messages. But yeah, wow. We got Mark Von Kugler.
Hello.
At the co-pilot seat today.
You will be terminated. No, not a good enough Arnold. I need to work on it some more.
Because you have the Arnold haircut.
I could get more Arnold.
Well,
you have the commando look going as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, well, Mark can pass for a governor, too, so I would say
the
so.
Governator.
The governator. Yeah, I get down.
Especially on Maria.
Where
is
but
the
what
notes?
If she's
okay,
the predator? Like.
Okay, and now she's his predator now.
Oh. It's too loud.
No, that's good.
That's awesome, man.
Okay, so let's get into it.
He didn't have his morning coffee yet.
I had my morning coffee.
Oh, that's true. This is midnight coffee.
Yeah, I didn't have my midnight coffee yet, which is supposed to be, as Killer Cat would have, like some sort of energy beverage right here. I can't mention names because, you know, we're not sponsored by them.
Oh, I can just imagine him spilling on top of that all.
It rhymes with Ronster.
That's why you bring a hydro flask and, you know.
It rhymes with Ronster energy drink.
Sounds like a song title. Or some kind of famous monster.
Okay, so this episode is the Night of the Living Dead episode, everybody. Wow.
That's why it started so slow. We're actually supposed to be dead.
We actually did talk about Night of the Living Dead.
It's a midnight on a Friday. How
when we had
be?
When we had the first episode of Friday Night Frights, when it started a long time ago. We started with zombies.
2 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah. Two summers ago. Can you believe that? 2 summers ago.
And most of the monsters.
Knowing that 2 summers ago, this is when you guys first started.
Yeah.
You must have lost track of the time.
I did lose track of the time, man. Why are you so soft over there?
I don't know. You got a bit of a hum again.
Yeah.
No, we can't get rid of that hum because Shaggy's got to work on it. Shaggy said, there's something wrong in here. Shaggy Jenkins, our... You know, our
illustrious leader
here at AKAKU 88.5 FM. Ooh, broadcasting out of AKAKU, Maui Community Media Center.
333 Dairy Road.
That's where we are right there. So, yeah, this is the Night of the Living Dead episode, and this one is dedicated to George Cosana. Yeah, he played Sheriff McClellan.
Yes, he passed away.
In Night of the Living Dead. He was like one of the last of the horror icons that passed away in December. 2016.
Yeah, 2016.
December,
yeah.
Yeah, December. The last ones. And then who took and who died at the beginning of this year for the Geek Nation?
Oh, it was the voice of Luigi from Super Mario Brothers Super Show. I forget his name, but yeah, he's gone now.
They're all going, man.
Mm-hmm. You're getting older.
Who's next? Adam West?
Hey,
Betty White, maybe.
Whoa.
They
have a Golden Girls reboot coming up. So.
Yeah, Golden. Yeah.
Wait, is she going to play the older woman now?
She's Sophia now.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
I can't wait if it's the Hot in Cleveland cast coming back for Golden Girls now.
I like Hot in Cleveland.
Yeah, I know. Hot in Cleveland was a good show.
But yeah, George Cusano, who played Sheriff McClellan from Night of the Living Dead, you know, they're dead. They're all messed up. Very famous quote. So let's get into it. I'm doing it differently right here. It's Night of the Living Dead fun facts and trivia stuff.
Okay.
So, you know, change it up a bit. So to get into it, the Holy Land of Night of the Living Dead is Evans City, Pennsylvania. And they shot it in the summer. And it went on all the way through December. In order to get
I was gonna say, because there were some scenes that looked like it was pretty darn cold. You could see a little bit of fog from the mouth.
A lot of the zombies and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And plus, all those zombies were townspeople.
And they were half of them were disrobed.
Yeah. And for
but
some
reason. You gotta admit, though, when you see a whole town willing to do a movie,
that's
when you know you had something good going.
You know how much they got paid?
Not much.
A dollar. A dollar and a T-shirt.
No, they didn't. They got paid in friendship.
I heard that they got paid in a dollar and a T-shirt.
They got food too.
And they got some food, hot stuff, free food. You know, intestines.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but who
it was slathered in. I heard that
chocolate sauce.
Yeah, chocolate sauce. Slathered
well, chocolate
in chocolate
looks great in black and white.
Yeah,
it was actually genius doing it in black and white. Because
isn't that what they use in Psycho with Norman Bates?
Psycho, and Psycho was for certain reasons on that regard too. But with black and white, you can use shading and backgrounds better than you can color.
Right.
Color, you can't get the contrasts.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. I remember watching back in the day Weekend of Horrors from Fangoria. It's a documentary, and on there they had the this is where it all started too. You know, the short film competitions and stuff.
Right.
And one of the films in there was it's not just for ice cream or something like that, right? And it's a whole scene where the guy is like freaking trying to cut open this freaking lady's scalp.
Ooh.
And it's basically it's just all chocolate syrup.
And it's not just for ice cream.
People don't know it, but in black and white films, we use Hershey's syrup as blood because red photographs is light gray.
Yeah.
So chocolate syrup. And she pulls out a freaking pencil and then pops it right in the guy's eye, and you see just chocolate dripping. I'm like, dude.
Nice.
I'm hungry now,
for real,
no
right?
Wonder, no wonder everybody wants to lick and
we
eat
need the midnight chocolate going on here. So,
did you know the initial investment?
The initial investment is it was about $114,000.
No, right? It goes before that. Each actor put in $600.
Oh, yeah. Everybody had a stake in the movie
right,
as well.
Right, a stake in the movie. So that's how they got things going.
And steak? I'm hungry now.
chocolate covered steaks.
Oh, gross.
And then after they got things started, then they started getting investors coming in with a few thousand here or there. And the other.
Yeah, but what happened with the outcome, what happened is it didn't trademark or copyright their whole thing. Image 10 Entertainment, which was the company that they created, it was like non-existent after, and like very non-existent.
Right.
Turkey baster.
There you go. we are not going to let that go.
Did you guys like what I did with that freaking show?
Yes, Chucky.
Turkey baster. Chucky. Tyler,
Chucky holding a turkey baster. That's the next movie.
I tried to make it.
I'm not going to lie. I have to deal with Gannon saying this from how long ago when Dope Breed first came out.
He's
like, hey, Swan, turkey baster, accused pinball machine. Turkey baster, pinball machine. Like, stop it, Gannon. Stop.
Yes.
And then it's like, now here it comes again. I'm like joke finally died out. Then it just hits me. Okay, we're back to turkey baster. Okay, are you guys going to get on pinball machines now?
Yes.
No.
Okay, cool.
We need it. Pinball turkey baster machine. You pop the freaking ball in with the turkey baster. And then the flappers, the things.
Yeah.
Those are turkey basters as well.
And they shoot little liquids out when you hit them?
Yes, yeah.
And bumper guards.
Yeah. Semen.
Well, you have to have it colored so you can see it.
A conditioner then.
Yeah.
We'll put conditioner.
Put a little green in there.
Do you have the notes on there?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. Let's drop it. Okay, what was the next thing? That's the last page.
Oh, the first is the last?
Yeah, the first is the last. Remember, I texted you back. I'm sorry. It was a bit backwards.
I heard something.
How's that sticks on a plane poster behind you guys? I heard somebody got that at an auction or something.
Oh, yeah. That was from a certain auction at a certain store.
Ah.
Yeah, from certain people who are there.
I can say what's the name of the store. Mario comic books and collectibles.
Oh, no. I don't want to say the...
You guys have any more?
You know what? Those are all on donation. By the next trade night, we should have some more posters in to do another auction. All
right.
I still laugh at the fact people bid high on the Sex and the City 2 poster, but yet nobody bid high on Snakes on a Plane.
Let me know when Night of the Living Dead comes in.
Oh, that's not coming in for anything.
Oh, come on.
No, not out.
How about the gate?
No, it's all current posters. Nothing really old. It's all if someone donates.
There's reprints of stuff.
Still, it has to come in on donation. If it doesn't, it doesn't.
Shucks.
I mean, the fun donation we had was with the actual box from Disney was the Nightmare Before Christmas posters. And those came in all the pins. That. See, that's the only thing
I'm not a real big fan of it. I mean, I enjoy it, but I'm not a real big fan.
I mean, it's not highly rewatchable to me. Like, I gotta watch it.
But we're talking about Night of the Living Dead.
Yeah.
Okay,
and you just digress the poster, sir.
So the house that was used in Night of the Living Dead, the main farmhouse, a very fine wooden house. It's gone now.
Yeah, it's gone.
It's gone. You know what's in its place?
You're going to tell us.
Turf farm.
Growing grass.
This exists.
Yeah, no. I was just making sure.
This exists. I was like, what?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I was like, there's some kind of warehouse someplace where they have it all. But I'm like, wait.
No, there's actual farms for it.
Yeah, no. It's that's expensive.
You ever saw those people keep off my grass? That's because they buy it.
I'm moving to Evans City. I'm gonna get a job at the Living Dead Museum.
Well, I'm gonna be a turf farmer. Run for Your Life, right?
Turf farmer on the weekend.
Have you ever saw the Run for Your Life thing?
No.
It's done by Comic Book Man had an episode of it, but pretty much it takes place where Night of the Living Dead was shot.
Really?
Yeah. It's a 3K race, and it's an obstacle course. Also, Mike Zapsik, Ming Chen, they got to do the course.
I remember that episode. Yeah.
It's an old thing, but still, maybe one day we all should go there and compete.
Yeah.
Dress up as Night of the Living
Dead. That would be like my mecca. Evans City, Pennsylvania.
You see Tony just smoke all of us by shoving us into the zombies. I'm gonna outrun you. I just gonna outrun them zombies. Ha!
Yeah.
No, I'm gonna go full berserker, man. That freaking just run.
He's gonna scare the zombies because he's gonna come with Nerf guns and plastic knives and start throwing.
I'm going in there with like freaking like some foam Lucille's.
Yeah, but you will need makeup. You're too brown.
No, he'll just wear his Jason mask. Yeah, you'll wear his hockey mask and just run up to people.
Well, copyright laws. I can use a version of it.
Oh, no, I mean, just go buy a goalie mask. I mean, Casey Jones gets away with it. You can.
Like the goalie mask on the part 5 poster.
Yeah, kind of. Is part 5 when he goes to New York?
No, part 5 is the one where it's not even Jason.
Which one is that?
Somebody's like impersonating Jason. Well, I've never seen
part 5. Wow.
Oh, it came right after part 4.
Never saw part 4 either.
Neither I stopped at 3.
Part 4 came after part 3.
I stopped at 3.
You stopped at 3.
Yeah. And then, you know, I had to sadly watch Jason X, so that's a level here.
Actually, well, Jason X was just on TV.
You didn't see part 6, then Jason Lives, where he comes back from the dead.
Oh, no. No.
And then part 7, where he rises from his watery grave. Part 7.
The psychic?
That's the one with the psychic.
Yeah, I saw that one.
Okay.
Yeah, I skipped
it. And then after that is Manhattan.
Okay, Manhattan. You know what? That movie, I wish the Muppets showed up. Like, the Muppets had a little...
It would have been trippy, right?
You know, like, Miss Piggy just nutshots him. Could you imagine that?
Together again.
Wait. Well, hey there, Annie. Mr. Hockey Player.
Why did the Muppets take Manhattan song?
Come on, you want
I think
see?
It is Together Again.
You know, I want to see
Somebody's getting married.
Versus Jason.
Somebody's getting married.
Somebody's getting married.
Now, having Kermit.
Kermit and Animal, the drummer.
Animal would take him down.
Yeah. Mm. And Miss Piggy, of course.
What about
Kermit the Frog would just talk him to death.
Or Sam the Eagle.
Oh, Kermit. Kermit.
Okay, so.
Okay, we're getting off track here.
We're getting way off track.
Getting way off track. So, the Evans City Cemetery was the chapel was going to be demolished, and there were sections of the cemetery that they was going to tear down because of, you know, I guess county ordinance and stuff like that. They raised at least $50,000 to keep that up. I remember back when this was a thing on MySpace in the horror community.
What's a MySpace?
Oh my God! It is a space.
You're dating yourself, dude.
I only had a Friendster.
Oh,
and my AOL account.
Oh, no. Prodigy. And...
Oh my goodness.
Yes. Oh. Uh huh.
ASL.
Oh my goodness. Oh.
H6 location. Chat rooms. Rock and roll.
300 baud. And that was high living.
Oh, I find hot chicks that are just like me, you know, guys in their basements or something.
Was one of them Alan?
Yeah, no.
No, it's illegal.
I knew what he was talking about. That I knew that one chick was like all about the booze.
Now, let's be nice.
I love him. He's a great guy. He's a great guy.
Yeah, he'll
can't wait to have him back. We gotta get him back. Like maybe if we started talking about, dude, we're doing an episode about Star Trek.
About Chekhov checking off.
And he'll sit right here.
Well, I'm going to diverse again if I go down that road. What about Night of the Living Dead?
Okay, Night of the Living Dead. In Evans City, there's a museum completely dedicated to Night of the Living Dead and all of George A. Romero's films.
I almost want to say Museum of Natural History, in this case, Unnatural.
Unnatural, undead.
History,
yes.
Wow, that's actually really cool.
And it's weird, too, because when I went up on the site, they have, like, collectibles and nothing from, like, Night of the Living Dead, like, from their town or something like that. It's, like, pieces of rock from Day of the Dead where they were underground.
Oh, okay.
So that tunnel system, that underground system they was using. Yeah. Looks like fun, though. I'd go
that's
there.
That's cool.
So... my Mecca, that's my vacation spot. Somebody get, like, I'm going to start a Kickstarter.
So instead of Disneyland, Disney World, or Mickey and Minnie, you're going to go for rocks.
I'm going to go for rocks in every city, Pennsylvania.
And grass.
And grass.
And lots of grass.
Lots of grass. Outlandish trivia. When the zombies are eating the bodies in the burnt out truck, they were actually eating roast ham covered in chocolate sauce.
Oh, yeah.
Filmmakers joked that it was so nauseous inducing that it was almost a waste of time putting the makeup on the zombies as they ended up looking pale and sick anyway. Reader's Digest tried... You remember that? Is that still a thing?
It is.
Yeah.
Reader's Digest tried to warn people away from watching the film in 1968 by claiming if it's watched, it will inspire cannibalism.
He had killed more than a dozen people and eaten some of them.
You know something? I will be one of those guys, Emily. Okay, we got a bunch of roast beef chocolate sauce for these zombie actors.
Yeah.
So, how many people do we have? Let's make something phallic out of them and watch them eat it.
No, they saved that for the independent films in the 80s.
I know. Just saying, it would have been funny. You just see one guy make it into like a thing. And the guy's like sitting there. He's like,
There is one.
Oh, I'm the odd man out. And eating this phallic looking one.
Wasn't it in Zombie Strippers where like a guy's like,
yes,
gets bitten off? Like,
yeah. But that one was made of gelatin, I was told.
Gelatin?
Yeah.
And then the I Spit on Your Grave 3.
Yeah.
You seen that one?
Snakes
I was
on a
like,
plane
what is that? Why all the snake got onto the...
Yeah, when the guy was taking a piss.
I'm surprised you didn't go for a Bill Cosby reference on that one.
Oh, the jello pudding.
Pudding pop.
You can't do it?
No, I can't.
During the filming of the cemetery sequence, shot on two separate days, an unexpected accident caused a fast change of script. The car driven by Barbara and Johnny in the cemetery was actually owned by Johnny's mother and the actor.
Right.
And unfortunately, sometime between the two filming sequences, someone ran and put a dent into it.
Yeah, because that...
Yeah.
And they utilized it really well by having to go up against a tree.
Yeah.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
That was a trip. I mean, you know, George was like, we'll make this work. Come on, it's guerrilla filmmaking.
Well, you know, directors named George Lucas and...
George Romero.
Yeah, they all come up with good things.
THX-1138. Yeah. So... Do I have more trivia in
here? Yes, you do.
I do. Oh, okay.
Making them smaller.
I make them smaller. So the next trivia is that the Tom Savini was going to do the makeup for Night of the Living Dead back in 1968. The reason why he didn't get to is because he was drafted.
Oh, wow.
He was drafted right before...
Vietnam.
Yeah, he went to Vietnam and he became a...
Vietnam was actually a war that we were participating in, but...
Participating in, but it wasn't our war.
No.
No, that was like when America's like, what? Those guys fought and I need to fight with them. Let's go, guys.
Let's go. Forrest Gump.
You know, then there was Tex. He was from Cleveland.
There's Tex.
Then there was Cleveland. Who was from Ohio. Then there was Wichita, but I don't know where Wichita was from. I was just...
You went off on a rant there.
So wrong.
I don't know. I never watched that movie.
Tom Savini went to Vietnam. He became a combat photojournalist.
Oh, wow.
Just like in Heavy Metal Jacket.
Whoa.
He was a combat photojournalist. And that kind of like that kind of like set him off to be more of a great makeup artist because he saw so much just death and destruction out there. But at the same time, I think that's Greg Nicotero I'm thinking of. Greg Nicotero was supposed to be a medical doctor and became
still,
a special effect.
But
they worked with Tom Savini, and he came back, and he became a stuntman. He worked on Dawn of the Dead, and the rest is history.
Mm.
But Tom Savini was supposed to be in Night of the Living Dead. And he was young. I think he was like, 19?
Getting drafted.
Yeah. And he's from the same town, I think. I think he's from PA. And one last thing I want to get into. Atlantis trivia. Some of the groans made by S. William Hinsman, Bob Hinsman, when he was wrestling with Russell Strainer, there's Johnny, in the cemetery are authentic.
Mm.
During the struggle, Strainer accidentally kneed Hinsman in the groin.
Oh, no! Oh, Johnny! Help me! Ah.
So they didn't change
the extra drums are coming from.
Yeah, when it's going like so the first zombie sound was attributed to getting kneed in the balls.
That it does hurt.
And now everybody is doing that's the sound of
trying to make a zombie.
That's the sound of a guy with his
Tony, all I'm hearing is they need to hire me on these sets. I run up and kick every zombie in the nuts. And we'll have a more believable
authentic
zombie. Okay, Walking Dead's doing it wrong. All right, Mark, looks like we have jobs.
Yep.
On to topic two, the copycatting movies, the remakes, the sequels, the movies that
spin-offs
tried to emulate what Night of the Living Dead was, you know.
See, that's where I believe they can't, though.
Yeah,
you can try all you want, but it had its own unique thing that you can't grab.
The one thing
that's true about almost any spinoff. You have you have the
like it won't be as successful.
Austin Powers movies trying to be Bond-like and it just doesn't work.
Yeah, but the Austin Powers movies are a whole different story. Like, they keep trying to throw some kind of weird stuff in
there.
Like, yes, I'm a lot of Fachida.
Right.
I'm Ivano Humpalot. Like, that's...
What?
But those were literal spinoffs of Bond. How they had some very funny or interesting...
We're talking about Night of the Living Dead. You guys talk about Austin Powers.
We're talking about spinoffs.
Yeah.
The spinoffs. Okay,
come on, stick with it.
Yeah, okay, stick with it. The remake, though...
Mm-hmm.
I thoroughly enjoyed. Directed by Tom Savini.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
And every road out,
don't stop no matter what happens,
is just another dead end.
They're coming right for us.
George Romero's Night of the Living Dead.
Yeah, it was a good one. Tony Todd, Candyman, played the Ben character.
Mm-hmm.
And then Patricia Tallman.
But he's also in Star Trek Next Generation.
He's in a bunch of the Star
Worf's
Trek.
Brother.
Yeah.
Boy,
he
has a long list
he's quite successful.
And I like the...
I believe, sir, you have a text message.
Huh?
No, that's music.
Oh, that's the music?
Music. Ha, 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 ha.
Stick with it.
So, anyways, the remake... Pretty much is this one stayed true to the original script, whereas Barbara was the survivor.
Yes.
Right, Barbara was survivor. She didn't go quite as cuckoo.
No,
in the original movie.
No.
But I liked it when the original. Yeah, she had him just going.
She's
crazy.
She's
she played it very well.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. She really sold.
It's not
shock.
Easy.
It was just how shock should be.
Audiences that see it now look at her as being wimpy.
Mm-hmm.
Audiences that saw it then saw it being more authentic.
Now,
you know what?
I'm glad we got into this because everybody's so critical about Night of the Living Dead now.
Yes.
They're like, oh, it's so
atrocious.
It's
a classic. I mean,
you can't watch it. It's too gritty and grainy. But that's what George wanted.
Yeah. And my whole part I hate is like, they're like, look at that one part where the guy is nailing the zombie to the ground. He's missing the head because he's going too far forward. I was like, well, back then you wouldn't know. It's believable.
Yeah.
Like, I believe everyone should just accept the movie for what it is.
I do. I freaking, this movie is the reason why I'm like a big horror geek.
Mm-hmm.
I remember watching Night of the Living Dead on Halloween night.
Well,
eating
my Halloween almost beyond candy. That, it really started the horror.
It started something.
Granted, you had the Mummy and you had Dracula and all that before Nosferatu.
Yeah. But the whole idea
kicked it into a higher gear.
Yeah, the whole idea of a living zombie coming up from the grave,
mm-hmm.
eating your flesh.
Right.
It's basically the whole idea of, like, you know, consuming each other.
Yeah.
The consumption of America. That's what Night of the Living Dead is all about. And racism.
No, actually not. Romero said himself that in the original, he didn't view Ben's character being black or white.
Oh, yeah,
so when
that's
he
right.
got
yeah.
shot, he looked at it as another person accidentally being shot.
Yeah.
Not a black man getting shot. And that's where America went, whoa, off on another direction. Oh my gosh, it's a call because the black guy got shot.
The first
that's
viral.
Not Romero's intent.
That was the first viral that came to
the
like, oh my gosh, it's a reason.
that's why they shot him. I guess.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And then
but,
in the
it's
remake,
kind of, it's hard to like say so because when you see someone just walking out slowly, and
right. You and from
easy,
a distance.
Right. Yeah. It's easy to mistake him for an undead person.
True,
yeah.
True.
And
true.
Everyone's like, man, that guy was racist while making that movie. He made sure the black guy died. I'm like, no, he didn't. Did you not see how far the guy is shooting the gun was?
But yeah, but
this also
only black guy in the movie too. So,
but this also the movie came out at almost the same time that Martin Luther King was assassinated.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That fueled
the
fire.
It was like just a year after, right? Like 67, 68.
Yeah, I thought it was within
it was
months, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, that must have really stirred some emotions.
Oh gosh,
still,
yes.
Like
so that's where a lot of that. Black versus white in this regard in this movie really got fueled, and yet that wasn't
like
Romero's
the first
intention.
Strong black character though too, like the first black lead character
strong
in horror.
Yeah, no,
in
he
horror.
Did a
so
damn good job.
Yeah. Who they had back then? What, Sydney Poitier?
Yeah,
that's it.
I like the fact that in the original movie that he said, "This is I'm boss up here. You're boss down there. Go down there."
Yeah.
He set the standard.
Yeah.
And that really was not a thing during the 60s to the point where, you know, you look back on Star Trek. Sorry for the jog. But, you know, Uhura being the first black commander.
Yeah.
On a military operation. That was huge.
And she continued the show because of Martin Luther
exactly
King.
Exactly right.
Whole fact
he
about
yeah, he came up to her and said, "I am so inspired by you. Please don't stop." And she was ready to give it up.
Amazing, right?
Oh, yeah.
Ah, Martin Luther King.
And in the remake.
He had a dream.
In the remake, I like that Barbara, the character, shot the white dude that was trying to be all bossy.
Oh, the
and,
asshole.
Oh, yeah, right. Exactly. Oh, yeah, another one for the fire.
Another one
and
for
the dudes
fire.
Are looking at it like, okay, well, all right, the fire.
She knows. This guy was nothing but a waste of space.
Well, I just
get him
let
out of
the
there.
Door open and let him go out there. Just let him try and make a run for it.
Well,
but at that point,
yes. That was at the end of the movie, so, yeah.
So, besides from the remake, there's also several other movies that claim the Night of the Living Dead title.
Or Living Dead style.
Yeah, the Living Dead style. Return of the Living Dead came out, and that was basically tried to be like a parody and tried to base, you know, like Night of the Living Dead was based on a true story and, you know, the tanks are downstairs. But completely own entity away from Night of the Living Dead.
It was a departure, although I really liked Return of the Dead Part 2. That one was almost funny. It was so...
That was parodying the first one.
Right.
It was a parody within a parody.
Yeah.
Next to the parody.
Yeah.
And then part three, you're like, oh, okay, this is the 90s generation.
Yeah.
Right. We're getting
piercing herself all over the place.
Well, yeah, and it gets into that whole thing. They're going to drive it into
the
ground just to make another buck.
Yeah. And then I don't know what the hell was Necropolis and Rave to the Grave was all about. But they're saying they're in the talks of remaking the whole series.
Yeah, because it can't come up with a new storyline.
I like how like everybody that in the 2000s, so the millennium people, was like, "Oh yeah, 2080s, all Dawn of the Dead, running zombies." Hello, Return of the Living Dead came out in 1985.
Yeah,
that's the first running
Dawn
zombies.
Dawn of the Dead.
Huh?
Sorry, I'm thinking Yoga for this year. Dawn of the Dead was the first running zombies, and that was done so long ago.
And what did Romero say about running zombies?
I don't know, Mark. Why don't you tell us?
He said that zombies could not run because they're in the ground for so long.
Well,
they get up,
they
start moving around,
the
they're going to break their ankles just trying to move quickly.
Not to mention, if it's a freshly dead person that comes back as a zombie, they have rigor mortis.
Yeah.
Or
the
muscle
stiffness.
Yeah.
Like, that's why I like Night of the Living Dead a lot more than Dawn of the Dead, because Dawn of the Dead, you can tell it's just so cheesy.
Yeah.
It's like,
sprinting.
And then when you see, like, Night of the Living Dead, it's like, as slowly as these things move, they manage to get you better than the ones after you.
Yeah, it's a tank instead of a motorcycle.
Yeah.
But you gotta give it up for the original Dawn of the Dead. The original Dawn of the Dead in the mall.
Oh, yeah.
All locked in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's one of my favorites. And then Day of the Dead.
Day of the Dead was a favorite for me.
Yeah.
Just that one part.
That was the goriest of them all, too, you know? So other remakes that came out is the god awful Night of the Living Dead 3D.
Oh yeah.
With Sid Hayes.
You know, I barely bothered with that. Was it that bad?
Yeah, it was
bad. Awful.
How many parts was 3D?
Not too many.
Yeah.
So it's pretty much a waste of a 3D.
Actually, it was like certain parts, and then when it gets to the part, they tell you to put on the glasses, and it's actually the old school 3D.
Yeah,
where they go from
red and blue.
Red and blue, and that colors. I'm like, get bent. I actually got the thing for like free because this one guy I was ordering old 70s grindhouse adult films from. Said, you want this? You can have it. It's a piece of crap. Thank you for 42nd Street, Pete. I love that piece of crap. I think I threw it away. Right after that came the Night of the Living Dead, also 3D reanimation with Jeffrey Combs. And I forget the other guy's name, but he was the character that played Wishmaster.
Oh, yeah.
That guy. Yeah, it was supposed to be like an origin story, too, where like, this is what really happened. There was a toxic spill in the mortuary and stuff. I'm like, God, get bent. Really, you guys are crazy. But, I didn't really like that one. There's a whole bunch, too. There's an animated Night of the Living Dead, mm-hmm. which has Tony Todd reprising the role of Ben as the voice.
Oh, wow.
So I haven't seen that one yet. I got to check that one out.
Some of these are really tough to get a hold of.
Yeah. But the second one that I want to talk about, the one that I really like, and it's not even like a Night of the Living Dead movie. There's not even zombies in it. It's called Mimesis, Night of the Living Dead. And the story of it is these group of horror geeks...
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going out to a party, and they're on the same area where the original Night of the Living Dead was shot. So, you know, they're big horror geeks. But what they get drugged, and then they wake up in a random farmhouse in the middle of nowhere, and there's zombies. They're at this farm. They wake up, you know, they're like, what the hell is going on? Next thing you know, they're being attacked by zombies, or so-called zombies.
Mm-hmm.
Turns out they're actually a group of people that want to live Night of the Living Dead. They want to bring it to life.
Okay,
right. They take random people, kind of like a hostile deal, like Saw, you know, and they just terrorize them. Like maybe strangers, like the strangers, or. But they're actually psychos with sharp teeth. They put in these sharp. Like pop-ins.
Right.
And if they get a hold of anybody that's inside the house, they're going to bite them. They're going to rip their throats out. Yeah. It's that serious. And they're playing a game. It's a cat and mouse game kind of movie, too, because they're just playing with them. They're actually in the inside. They try to board up the windows and everything, and they're trying to figure out what the hell is going on. And then it gets to the point where you find out that these guys are doing it just for fun. Because they want to live out Night of the Living Dead. And it's crazy. But then, like every horror movie is like that, where you keep somebody captive and terrorize them.
Mm-hmm.
The one that's been terrorized always
fight back.
Yeah. Yeah, so they end up getting killed all in the end. Which is a really good movie. I liked it. I haven't gotten it on DVD myself, so... Possibly one day with a good paycheck, I'm going to pick that one up on DVD or Blu-ray or whatever. But it's a really good one. You should check it out. The first time I saw it was on Showtime. You know, back when we were able to afford Showtime.
Well, either that or become a new subscriber and get it free for 60 days.
60 yeah. days, and after 60 days,
$39.99.
Or you then you catch one of those deal breakers during like the holidays. They have cable deal breakers during the holidays.
That, you know? Or around like Super Bowl time.
You get if you pay this right now, you get this channel for free for the whole year kind of deal.
Right now, it's Epics.
Yeah. Epics?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Missed out. You should get it. But anyways, yeah.
Oh.
That's pretty much it. But wow, we only got 15 minutes, but. So what are your thoughts on the Living Dead series?
Oh, I hear nothing but negative things about it now versus how I used to hear it when I was still in school. I believe people should just accept the movie for what it is. I find it one of my personal favorites. And I show it to my kids at home because they are starting to turn into big horror junkies. And they're just...
Yeah, I heard. You showed your niece Psycho the other day.
Citizen Kane. Yeah, and she's just like all into it. So right now she's watching Night of the Living Dead at home.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Original black and white.
Original black and white.
That's the only way to go, man. Yep. I don't know about this colorized version.
Well, because she's watched all the new modern things like Lights Out, Don't Breathe.
Oh, yeah.
Like, stuff like that. And she's like, this is awesome. I'm like, wait.
Turkey baster.
Yeah. Go check this stuff out. And then she's just like, oh, wow, this is actually really cool, too.
Yeah.
Like, that's chocolate syrup.
There is not... Okay, there's going to be a rant topic right now because there's not enough like horror geeks now or horror fans now that appreciate the classics.
Well, yeah, they appreciate the art. And
the art of the classics.
Yeah, I'm all about the classics. Yeah. I don't really care too much for the newer stuff nowadays. I mean, yeah, you have some expensive effects, but still, back then it looked more realistic than how it does now.
There's,
and too many movies...
It's more believable.
Too many movies are in the vein of let's throw it up against the wall and see if it sticks.
Yeah.
We can't come up with the original storyline, let's remake it for the 15th time.
But then you can tell they're just doing it for money.
Exactly. And that's like, why it's
right. Romero guys, they actually wholeheartedly love this film,
right?
And that's why
Romero
it worked.
Yeah, Romero's trying to like with the sequels that came out after Land of the Dead, Survival of the Dead, Diary of the Dead.
There's a Diary of the Dead.
Yeah, there's a Diary of the Dead.
Oh, I thought you were kidding.
Yeah,
no, I'm not kidding. This is actual. This is real.
What year was this?
Well, Land of the Dead came out like 2001.
Oh, was it really 2001?
Yeah, that's the one where John Leguizamo turns into a zombie.
And then they're trying to hunt down the convoy tank and get it back because they have missiles. And then the zombies find the way into the town.
Dude, it's a good movie. I like it.
Oh, yeah. It was a fun movie. I just like the part where all the zombies had them trapped at the power lines.
So, and Diary of the Dead.
Does she write in the diary and the dead people come to
life? No. It's actually shot. It's like a found footage style.
Oh, Blair Witch Project? Or
yeah. Mm. About a group of kids that are shooting a horror movie out in the woods while the zombie apocalypse starts to happen.
Right. So they think it's all fantasy and then it turns on them.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's like everywhere they go, it's just zombies after zombie attack and stuff. Survival of the Dead takes one of the characters from Diary of the Dead and continues their story on. And it, like this whole BS storyline about the zombies are capable of, you know, kind of like Bub. Like Bub the Zombie from Day of the Dead, like you know, the intelligence. They tried to figure out the intelligence level, right?
Okay.
And then it's this whole Hatfield and McCoy storyline in the background.
Right.
It's like, what the? I don't know what George was trying to think of, but I like it for the zombie stuff. I like it for the zombies, but he was trying too hard.
That was a little bit of a forced story.
Yeah. I think he cannot repeat what he made with the originals.
Well, like
Land of the Dead was okay. Diary of the Dead was kind of cool. Survival of the Dead was kind of cool too, but it was you got lost in translation in the storyline.
Yeah, and this happens a lot with athletes and others that peak too early.
Yeah.
And then where do you go from top? You go down.
Bottom, that's right.
Yeah. What's Kobe Bryant doing now?
Who?
Who?
I thought he had good steak with chocolate.
That's right. Covered. Smothered in gravy.
I really don't know who you're talking about.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. He's from the Lion King.
Now, if you talk Steph Curry, everybody... Oh, hey!
Lion King. Okay, yeah.
You know, Bo Jackson. It's like, who?
John Cena. What's that guy?
Right.
So, while we're on the topic
Costello.
I heard they meet a Wolfman.
Three Stooges.
They did. And Frankenstein.
Yeah, I watched those.
Oh, God. No.
Laurel and Hardy in prison.
The whole whole Universal remake deal going on.
Oh, are you mad about the Tom Cruise playing in The Mummy?
Oh gosh, no, please.
So because I heard a rumor that Rock is the Wolfman.
Here's why it's ruining it for me.
Well, you grew up with the classics, and you love them.
I love the classics. I mean, it's Boris Karloff, right? I mean, it's classic.
Well, he's an actual actor. And I'm not saying anything against Dwayne Johnson. He's good.
I was very entertained by the remake from the 90s. The Mummy 2,
yes.
Oh, yeah.
Those are actually pretty good.
Those are pretty
good. Again, they had decent acting.
Yeah.
They had a good storyline.
Did you like Tomb of the Dragon Emperor with Jet Li? Where the Yetis were playing football.
To an extent, yeah. I liked it. Because,
and dragons
were
coming down with an undead army at their side.
Yeah, I liked Forbidden Kingdom, so anything with Jet Li, I'm going to like find some way to like it.
Hey, Jet Li and One. Now, there was a good movie.
Jet Li what?
You never watched the movie One?
Oh, the one where he's jumping through the dimensions
just
to get energy from all the copies of him? Mm-hmm.
Jet Li and Expendables.
Oh, no.
That's why they called it Expendables, because all the actors have had it.
Terry Crews was more entertaining than Jet Li in the Expendables.
Chuck Norris was as entertaining as everyone else.
He was only in the sequel.
Yeah, but that's the only one I watched.
Okay, yeah. So the sequel is the best one. But what was I talking about?
Tangent. Oh, we got him. We tripped him up.
We're talking about NES and Nintendo's.
Right.
Oh, we were talking about zombies and stuff.
Did you watch Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies? Now that.
Onto my rant about the generation, the next, this generation.
Michael Keaton is the creature from the Black Lagoon.
He's Ray Kroc from McDonald's.
Respecting
it again.
The classics.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you
got to remember now. It's hard to come up with an original thought because all of it's been done.
I know, but we need more kids nowadays to be like, "Oh God, like, have you seen Reanimator?"
I actually like that one.
You know, like, have you seen? Let me think of like an old freaking horror movie. Like, have you seen Let's Scare Jessica to Death? Psychological supernatural horror flick, right? Have you seen The Omen?
Yeah, the Omen series was good. Well, the first one was really good. Second one, not too bad. Third one started losing it.
People Under the Stairs is a fun one for me.
People Under the Stairs? Yeah, that's a good classic.
She's been feeding that thing in the walls. Then you see Roach.
They're all cannibals, too.
Yeah.
I like that part where he's like cutting the meat and just grinding it. It's like, oh, yeah, tartar.
And they're all wealthy as heck.
Yeah, but there's so much horror movies out there from back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, these new ones are entertaining. You know, they're putting in like a lot of CGI stuff. You know,
well, like I said, the super big special effects. Yeah, it's cool. It's nice. I don't find it believable. I can tell it's fake. Probably to these kids it looks real, but I like the fact that back then when claymation,
yeah,
were giant monsters, and could use certain stuff that makes it look more believable.
Like, again, you're losing the art.
Out of all of them, that was awesome. It was like a guy in a suit, but the way he could move in the water in that suit was so unbelievably awesome.
That's right.
It was my favorite classic. Universal monster. Yeah. Yeah, it's a classic.
So more and appreciation.
Like, then we go back to the art.
I've heard
the art of them trying to do that.
I've actually heard kids like say like, "Oh, I like all of the new stuff. I don't like that old stuff. What is black and white?"
Yeah.
No, you know something?
But did they watch it? That's the point.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Did they watch it?
That's my grandpa's time. I was like, your grandpa's time was a lot better.
Yes, it was. It's a lot better. You know how much movies Universal Studios put out? It was just only Dracula.
Oh, no, there's tons.
There was tons. Murders in the Rue Morgue.
Even when my kids were growing up, they were anti-black and white. And I just picked out a couple of movies and said, no, we're going to sit down and watch this.
Yeah.
And come to find out, now there are certain black and whites. They're like, that is my ultimate favorite.
You know what makes me sad? In a while from now, probably like 100 years or so, what these new movies are will be called classic because there'll be better effects probably.
I don't know. That's going to be a tough one to sell.
You watch Star Trek Beyond.
We'll leave.
Like Beastie Boys is considered classical.
No.
Come on.
No.
Like, that's, you gotta
remember. I remember Beastie Boys.
Classical music.
Just because I know the name. That's it. Oh,
they stole that from Futurama.
Thank you.
They stole that from Futurama. Why is this the classical music? Is Baby Got Back. Have you seen that episode?
Yeah, no. Fry finds his old credit card, and he's apparently the richest man in New York.
The richest head?
Yeah, and he just goes and he's just like, I'm going to go buy this old school apartment. Ha ha, I bought anchovies. That's extinct now. Oh, I got classical music. And then they go, I don't like big buttons. I cannot lie. And like, stop listening to these old classical cassette tapes.
Right, right.
And get with the MP3s.
So, yeah, okay. Time for shout outs. That's our show.
Ah, okay, cool.
Shout outs.
If you guys want to check out some other cool shows, please tune into the Rave Corner for Tuesday Morning Shenanigans.
Yes.
By Aaron. And
we had them
really
on
cool
the Turkey
guy.
Baster show.
Yeah. He told me that's a very uncomfortable show. I asked him if there's any insertions, and he wouldn't answer.
Oh, God.
Another shout out to MAUI Comics and Collectibles. Also here.
Why would that be a shout out?
Why
is that a shout out?
Because we love
awesome,
them.
And they have a lot
and
of
what
their
do they have
comics.
There?
We're best friends with the.
Man, they have some cool horror comics. They got the new Tales from the Crypt series that came out.
Yes.
And they also had Tales from the Dark Side.
And they have anything that's represented on your shirt?
Oh. They also have Darkwing Duck.
Darkwing Duck.
Also, shout out to Save Darkwing Duck for Aaron Sparrow and James Silvani.
Save Darkwing. Hashtag
yes.
Save Darkwing, everybody.
Like that segue?
Yes. And also, one more show for if you guys want to hear about some real nerdy stuff in the movies and TV, tune in to NERDWatch. Every night on AKAKU at 7 o'clock Thursdays.
What's the guy's YouTube channel?
It's the NERDWatch Nation because NERDWatch has been used.
By who?
I don't know, some other guys.
Oh, God.
But it was hilarious when G found that out. But, yeah, check us out at NERDWatch Nation. Mark, to you, man.
If you're into podcasting and nerd podcasting, there's Rebel Force Radio. That's your source for the Force.
Oh, right on.
They're probably the leading.
Is that on YouTube?
No, it's podcasting.
It's podcasting.
Yes.
So it's iTunes and Audio Boom, right?
Yes, yes.
Oh, do they have a link to their...
I can give you a link.
I'll find a link. Yeah. I'll put it below, right by my penis.
You can find it on Facebook, Twitter,
next
so forth.
Next to my turkey baster.
Mm. Your giant-sized man thing.
I don't have that. I have my Suspiria.
Oh, my goodness. No,
give one more shout-out to Al Jawa. We need him back.
Yes, Al Jawa, get back on Friday Night Frights, buddy.
Not because of fun, because you are fun.
You are fun.
And fun-sized.
Fun-sized.
I mean, that dude's like a little plush animal. You can just pick him up and shake him and just like...
He's a Jawa.
Yeah.
He's a Jawa.
He's like my pet monster.
Yeah. I'll tell him you want to pet him.
No. I just
is there any little people in Star Trek?
Star Trek.
Oh, yeah.
Star Trek?
What's
Journey to Babel?
I don't know.
No, yeah. Like a small, pint-sized creature in Star Trek. What would Alan be? Like Scotty in the newer movies has that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you're going new school. I'm going
old
school. Old
school, is there anything?
Yeah, there was one episode called Journey to Babel, and they did have little people in that. I was also thinking Jawas.
Oh, okay.
In Star
okay.
Wars.
I was thinking Captain Caveman for a second, but Alan's not
Captain okay.
Caveman.
Okay.
Caveman.
By
okay,
the way,
so,
this year's Halloween. You all need to do that, family. I nominate Alan's new cousin in. I have a wig long enough for him.
Awesome.
Thing.
Okay, so for my shout-outs, I want to shout-out the Dorkening. Dorkening. Mahalo to them.
Nice.
They'll be giving us some intros of for some cool,
mean like with
awesome.
Lloyd Kaufman's intro.
Yes, we did get
yeah.
one last year, didn't we?
Yeah,
Lloyd
I
Kaufman
remember that.
Was so awesome, and they've been so good to us. They're like our brother company out there in the mainland. We gotta get out there and party with them at a convention or something, you know, like a weekend of horrors or something. You know,
and you gotta go to Pennsylvania.
We gotta go to
Evanston.
Let's all meet in Evan City.
You know what we gotta do? We gotta meet up with the Dorkening and have a road trip to Pennsylvania.
Yes.
Unless they're already based there, and then that's pointless.
Dude, travel vlog.
Oh, yeah.
Travel vlog.
roast beef
and
chocolate.
Yes.
That's the traveling foods.
I also want to give a shout out to TheRememberFire.com.
Is that where the shirt came from?
Yes, the shirt came from TheRememberFire.com. They always hook me up with the swag. All my swag is from TheRememberFire.com.
Once you've seen it, you'll never feel safe in the dark.
And a big shout out to the Carter Ohana. I hope everybody is doing okay.
Yes.
We hope to see Kaleo back on the next episode. They you know they're just wish them well because they're having some times and
health challenges.
So yeah, aloha to them. So yeah, that's Friday Night Frights for you guys. As we do every time at the end of the show,
as you guys do it.
Yeah, you guys don't do that in NERDWatch, do you?
No. I mean, I don't do it anyway. I'm on the show.
Okay, peace, Shaka. Tigahana.
Yeah, you went inside.
You don't like Tigahana Bada because you get Hana Kusu.
Hey.
Ha ha. What, bro?
We out.
We out, bro.